Hello there. I hope you are doing well and you are keeping safe during the lockdown period. I am Johnny Satella, and as I mentioned last week, I'm the coordinator of the Africa Research and Impact Network, in short known as ARIN. ARIN is a network of young African researchers across Africa who are focused on promoting or supporting research excellence in the continent. ARIN also provides capacity building for young aspiring researchers who want to venture into a research career and be able to pursue excellence in research and analytical thinking as well as thought leadership. So that is very critical for the Kent continent as we move towards the next decade of industrialization. We undertake weekly reviews, and as I mentioned during this time, we are focusing on our reviews mainly largely focus on research excellence. But during this time of COVID-19, we are focusing on how best our research and policy systems are basically responding to COVID-19, including what are the gaps, what are the opportunities, and what lessons basically can we learn for the future. So last week we focused on how subnational governments are, supporting the response to the COVID-19 process, and we highlighted a number of key things that came up. But again, this week our review focus was on how non-state actors, the community-based organizations, the civil society, the NGOs, the various networks, which are critical in supporting livelihoods of communities, are basically contributing to the process and the response to COVID-19. And to this end, we highlighted a few very key important observations that we wish to share with you. So our key researchers, Dr. Kennedy Liti, based in Australia, and Ms. Victoria Chengo, based in Nairobi, are going to share with you some of these insights.
COVID-19 has wreaked havoc across the globe, and countries everywhere have been struggling to contain the pandemic, including African countries. So we've seen different types of responses from various places in the world, and one of the most characteristic responses has been a lockdown, including African countries. So one big concern was what would happen to African countries that usually don't have social safety nets, yet they took some of the most drastic actions to contain the COVID-19 pandemic. And many observers and commentators made predictions that the COVID-19 pandemic would upend African politics as we know it, and it would lead to social chaos. But what we've actually seen in many parts of Africa is innovation, a lot of innovation, especially from the bottom up, where true state capacity is very much limited. But we've seen different types of actors, including private companies, community-based organizations, civil society, etc., coming together and creating networks to try to reach the most vulnerable people in society. And those networks have worked to complement state responses to the COVID-19. So, which begs a very interesting question on what are some of the characteristics of these initiatives, and who are the main actors that comprise these initiatives, and what can we learn from some of these initiatives?
Building on that introduction by Kennedy and Dr. Teller, I now go over some key ways in which these last mile initiatives have been supporting in the COVID-19 emergency response. Firstly, as the national governments remain at the forefront of providing COVID-19 response directives, corporate and community initiatives have been utilizing and mobilizing their existing networks and structures to deliver evidence and even relief to the vulnerable communities, complementing the efforts by the national governments and enabling a better response mechanism in overall. Secondly, awareness creation. African community champions continue to create and provide and even come up with more COVID-19 knowledge systems through the media, through art and even music. And these have been very effective in influencing the much needed behavior change among the communities. And thirdly, proper innovation and entrepreneurship. small businesses and public or private institutions have been driving local production of COVID-19 emergency response kits. Face masks, ventilators, and even hand wash machines, and some of which have been quite affordable to the poor and needy. These local innovations and production can be incubated and nurtured for future benefits. Number four, collaborations. We've seen new alliances being formed and even more collaborations among communities across borders, regionally, and even with international communities. This has been very key in facilitating the sharing of innovative technologies and even ideas of dealing or responding better to COVID-19 emergency. And this could be enhanced for future ways in which African countries can collectively respond better to this kind of pandemics. And lastly, partnership and sustainability. As we think, as we continue to figure out how to improve our mechanism for responding better to this kind of pandemics, we need to analyze and see how best to support these last mile initiatives and also adopt that last mile governance model for better preparedness in the future.
So having looked at the various lessons that we've learned from some of these last mile initiatives, what can we sort of summarize going forward? I think there are three key things to take note of. And the first would be these initiatives would be there for quite a while, even after the COVID-19 pandemic has been addressed. And the question would be then, would some of the networks still remain there? Would all the networks be there, or would all of them disappear? That would be a very interesting question to see how persistent these networks would be. I think the second thing would be understanding the nature of the networks, because they came, you know, out of the blues, bottom up, and we saw communities and people organizing and trying to build this network to address a gap that was there, and that is due to state capacity. The state or the government could not reach to everyone. So understanding how these networks operate and how they complement the state would be very interesting research agenda. And I think finally would be understanding how these networks can be made more resilient, because this is not the last pandemic. Hopefully it's the last pandemic of this scope, but there'll be many other policy challenges. So can we take the lessons learned from these last mile networks and apply them to these other problems that might emerge in the near future? I think those are three important things that we have to keep our mind on as we go forward.